Scott Lyons. I'm one of the owners of Tomahawk Construction. It's me and my brother. We've been in business since 04, so 21 years. We got into the site work industry, really started off house pads and small commercial. And by 2010, got up into doing land development and mining. So today we're on one of our mine sites out in LaBelle, Florida. It's a limestone aggregate pit. We have some Bell Teleo autonomous trucks on site, three of them.
My name is Mark Piotto. I'm the Vice President of Sales here at Teleo. Teleo's a five-year-old company. We're based out of Palo Alto, California. And we provide autonomous AI solutions for the construction and mining industry. So Scott had reached out to us through a mutual friend looking for a solution to combat his labor issues. He couldn't find operators that were willing to drive the 2 hours to Naples from Fort Myers. So we had several conversations about how Teleo can solve this problem. And since then it's been an amazing ride. You know, we started off with a few John Deere machines, and Scott introduced us to Bell America, and it's been good conversations with Bell America, and now we've taken those conversations on to the global headquarters in South Africa.
We sought out this technology because we always had trucks sitting, and it seemed like our truck drivers are somewhat of a revolving door. That's the first place we start, guys with no experience. You know, it seems like we always had trucks sitting. So at some point, Bell is gonna produce trucks out of the factory with these systems on it, which saves a lot of time in the hardware process of Teleo getting the trucks up and ready. Just this past couple weeks, Teleo was able to put a system on a truck in about a day and a half. Initially, the first John Deere trucks, it took about a month a truck to figure out the schematics and the custom hardware to secure the unit. With Bell doing a lot of the legwork at the factory, it's going to speed up the process. We typically like the lease trucks, but if we can get them Teleo ready right from the factory, it's a win-win for us.
Teleo was founded by two gentlemen, Vinay Shet and Ram Clement. They met each other actually at Google, where Ram developed all of the Google cars and backpacks and planes that took pictures of the Earth. And Vinay head up the team to stitch all that data together to bring us Google Maps and Street View. They went over to Lyft and started the self-driving car services at Lyft. They recognized that there was a tremendous opportunity to combine teleoperations and autonomy in the construction and mining space.
So, you know, we got a good relationship with NED, National Equipment Dealers. They are our Bell rep. And I tell you, when they saw what we were doing with Teleo, they got Bell involved pretty quick. And I tell you what, the response from Bell has been like no other. They've been pretty much as aggressive as we have on really the whole process. And the fact, shoot, even the owner of Bell out of South Africa was at this mine site here about a month ago. They see what we see. This is where this industry is moving to.
Scott's operations here in LaBelle, eventually they'll be his headquarters for his operators. On this specific site, he's got a mine site, which is gonna eventually turn into a residential site for the next 10 years. We're gonna have a few trucks bringing material back and forth, the operator sitting in a comfortable office environment. You know, when plans or routes change, the operator can change the route and re-record the path so that the trucks will be able to run autonomously from point A to point B. That's just the beginning though, because Scott's got other jobs that we are in the process of implementing. where he'll be able to run from LaBelle. He'll be his central headquarters. He's got three or four other jobs with some Bell trucks that'll be running from here in LaBelle in various places in Florida. The user interface within our control station allows the operator to hear the machine operation, allows the operator to feel a little bit of haptic feedback in the chair, and allows the operator to see 360 degrees around him. That experience, he can switch over from machine to machine in a millisecond. So that experience is, you know, you're bringing in machines to the loadout tool, and you're dumping machines at the dump location, and the driving in between part is just the supervising of the autonomous operations. Given the fact that we've got a blend of human operations and autonomy, that allows us to go into, you know, job sites like construction sites where, you know, there's a lot of fluidity on a job site. This isn't a fully autonomous solution on purpose. The operator's ability to record data, and we're using that data to inject more and more autonomy, is giving us a very bright future. I honestly see that we're going to be we're already in construction sites, mine sites, and various different industries, logging and forestry and things of that nature. But the reality of it is in the construction site, it will be more and more accepted because we have that human in the loop. Autonomy scares people. And when you have a human supervising that autonomy, they're not afraid anymore.
Now really, in the next 5 years, I would feel pretty positive to say that just about every company in the United States that moves earth or mining materials will be using this technology. Nobody goes to school anymore and says they want to work in the construction industry, or at least not driving an articulated haul truck or running a loader, right? So it's going to open up the doors with a different class of employee that we would typically hire to be able to sit in an office and operate trucks, loaders, dozers. It's not going away.
And at the end of the day, fully autonomous solutions, really, it's a very complex problem to solve. So when we bring in the human operations, the human has the ability to label data, and every time the human is interacting with the machine, we're learning more and more about how the operator operates machines and injecting more and more autonomy into the solution.